Hey guys, in this video I will talk about two different types of logic that exists in UI Builder. To demonstrate it real quick, I will just jump to the logic section for example, this button. And as you can see right here, there is a on-click event, and which is a type of logic. And there are also elements such as visibility logic, label logic, and disabled state logic. So this is very demonstrative of those two different types. The first type is an event. And in UI Builder, you will see those events, they always start with an on prefix. These events, they are executed when the user does something. In this case, the on-click event will be executed when the user clicks on the button. For instance, with the map component, there is going to be on pan event or on zoom event. So when the user interacts with the component and pans or zooms, those events will be triggered. It's very easy to detect the event handlers. The other type of business logic are not necessarily user-driven events, but they are events nonetheless. They really happen when a re-render event happens in UI Builder. And what that means is, for instance, for the button component, when that button is sitting inside of a page, or if that button is sitting inside of a block or a container, when the data model of that underlying page or container or block changes, UI Builder re-renders everything within that block or container or page. And whenever that re-render event happens, then every one of these handlers is going to be invoked, if it has data binding or it has logic. In this case, as you can see, there is no logic assigned to visibility, no logic assigned to label, and there is nothing for disabled state, and there is no data binding either. So all of this are going to be skipped. However, if we were to place data binding for visibility, label, or disabled state, then whenever a re-render event happens in UI Builder on that page, then this logic is going to be executed. Let me demonstrate this with a specific example. The example that I have is there is a button, and underneath the button there is a container, and that container has the dynamic list behavior. What I have programmed here with the codeless logic is when this button is clicked, and as you saw, there is this on-click event. So when the button is clicked, we load data from the database. There is a table called World Cities, and whatever this codeless block returns is being placed into page data with a property name called cities. This name here is important because it's going to be used in data binding. So at this point, just remember that we're loading a collection of world cities and they're being placed into page data with the property cities. Now let's say we click this button, we retrieve the data, place it into page data, and notice what happens. So I click the cities container, and let's go into the logic section for this container. And as you can see right here, there is data binding for the word cities. So what's going to happen is we click the button, retrieve data from the World Cities database, and we place that collection of cities into the page data mapped to the property name cities. Now in this case, we're executing dynamic items logic data binding. So this is a very good example, because when I click this button and retrieve data and I place it into page data, this re-render event will happen that will be re-rendering everything right here. It happens real quick, you don't really see it on the screen, but at this point the cities container, since it is data bound to that property in page data, it actually receives this data because it is in the data items logic. So the data items logic kicks in, the UI Builder runtime says, here's your collection of cities, and then the container goes off to do its work, which basically starts rendering this row and replicating it for every single city in that collection. And then the process of this re-rendering and data binding keeps on happening now at the row level. And specifically here, let's take a look at this text, which is right next to the label called city. Let's go to the event handler. And as you can see, for the content logic, it is mapped to the word city, which is the property in a specific city. It will probably help if I just show you the structure of that database. So this is my data table called World Cities, and as you can see, it's very simple. It has city, it has country, and then the geographic location, the GPS location of that city, which is in the properties lat and LNG for latitude and longitude. So super simple. So keep in mind there is a property city, country, lat and LNG. So let's go back and in here to render the name of the city, this text field has data binding to the property city, because at this point it's going to be operating on a single city object. And the reason it will be operating on the single city object, because we are in the row component, and that row sits in the container that has dynamic list behavior. So the container gets a collection of cities, and then it starts taking city by city in that collection and assigning individual city objects to each individual row. So any data binding that happens in this row will be executed on an individual city object. So let me run this page so you can see exactly how it works. This is the default state. So now if I click the button, the data is going to be loaded from the backend. The container will be initialized, and then the rows will start showing up. Let me do that. So now, as you can see, it fetched some cities from the backend, and then we initialized the map with a marker of where that city is, and we're using the lat and LNG properties for the cities, and then we display the city name and the country that that city is in. So the effect is pretty cool, and the amount of logic that it takes to do it is trivially small. Something interesting is happening in the map. Let me demonstrate this to you as well. Select the map and click the icon to go to the logic for the map. And in here, there are two handlers. One is for the map center logic, and the other is for the markers logic. So let's take a look at the map center logic first. And this logic is responsible to return an object that has LAT and LNG properties. And then the Google Maps is programmed to use that object to just center the map at the specified coordinates. Row 1 data contains the actual city object that contains the LAT and LNG properties. As a result, we can simply return row 1 data because Google Maps will find latitude and longitude inside of the city object that row 1 data represents. Exactly the same thing happens in the markers logic, with the difference that the markers logic needs to return a collection of objects, each of those containing latitude and longitude. In our case, we want to render just one marker. In this case, we create a new list, and that list contains the actual city object, which in turn has the LAT and LNG properties. So as you can see, very simple logic, and I hope this demo demonstrates the difference between the classical event handlers and just the handlers that are responsible for executing data binding and just returning data into the component through data binding. Thank you for watching this video, and as always, happy codeless coding.